Dith dar, as they say in my part of the world. Welcome from me, Martin Smith, aka Cornish Grandad, to my YouTube channel. I trust you're well and interested in learning more about Blender. In the previous tutorials in the series, we created objects from primitive shapes, planes, cubes and the like. In this tutorial, we'll be creating objects by directly manipulating the mesh by repeatedly using extrude, size and grab. We'll create a simple plate by distorting a circle using proportional editing, then applying new modifiers. Finally, we'll create a shiny bowl to catch the light, as in Raymond Campbell's Still Life. A bit of practical theory on meshes. Meshes are the fundamental structure of all three objects. Here we have a simple plane, subdivided into squares, or in CG language, quads. When modelling, we try to work where possible in quads. This second plane is subdivided into triangles or tries. When Blender or any other computer package renders an image, it renders out triangles, determining the light, texture, reflection, etc. for that triangle. Working out a triangle from a quad is dead easy. This third plane has meshes with more than four sides. These are called nGons, as in polygon. And I've highlighted the nGons for you to see. Now, when Blender tries to render this, where it puts the triangle is a bit of a lottery, so you can get unexpected results. Here is the famous Suzanne head. As you can see, it's made up of quads, though there are some triangles where the pupil of the eye focuses. There are no nGons, so it's a good quality mesh. Remember that in 3D packages we construct meshes mainly using quads, and the tools that help us to create meshes work best with quads. The rendering engine will turn quads into tries to create the image. Both the tools and render give unpredictable results when they encounter nGons. Here we created a subdivided cube and used a modifier, the Boolean modifier, to cut a sphere from one corner. The red faces are nGons. See what happens when we use the subsurface modifier to smooth out our object. The behaviour of the nGons gives weird results. So are nGons always bad? Well, when we create the cylinder primitive, it actually comes with an nGon at the end. But where possible, use quads. Triangles are okay, but can make manipulation of the mesh difficult, so I tend to use them right at the end. So this is the scene as we left it, our table and two chairs. Now we're going to create some objects to go on our table. Now objects by default are created at the 3D cursor, and our 3D cursor is currently sitting at the world origin, so the X, Y and Z axis all sit over there. And this chair is a bit of the way, I think. Remember, we've parented this chair, so we can move it out of the way by clicking on the seat, grab y-axis, just slide it out of the way for a bit. There we go. And let's hide this floor while we're at it. So with the floor collected, floor selected, hit H, and as you can see up here in our collections, the floor's grayed out and the little eye symbol is shut, showing it's not going to be there. So we're going to create this metallic fruit bowl by taking a sphere and cutting the top of it. So add mesh UV sphere. Wow, that's big. We could reduce the segments and rings, but I want a lot of detail in here because I want it to be very smooth. So I'm going to leave it as it is. But the size is far too big and it wants to be a radius of about 15 centimeters. There we go. Now, often when we've got objects, we want to be able to zoom in and just focus on the object. And the way to do that is view frame selected, or the number pad dot, which is does that, zooms in nicely for us. We use this quite a lot. And as I haven't got a number pad on my laptop, I'd like to add this to my quick favorites. So if we go view frame selected, but instead of left clicking it, we right click it. We add the object option to add to quick favorites.
So now if I press Q at any time, I'll get my list of my quick favorites, and there's that frame selected one I did before. So if I go Q, frame selected, it was zoom in on that for me, which is not, but in mind. Okay, so let's look at this, and we'll use a right hand view because then we haven't got the table in the background. What I want to do is cut the top off. So we go into edit mode, and if I box select, so click and drag those, I've selected all those top cursors. I really want to be in, yeah, that'll do. But notice, actually, I haven't selected them all. I only selected the ones I could see. The ones behind are not selected. So I need to go into wireframe mode. And remember, in wireframe mode, there's two options, xRay on and xRay off. So if we have xRay off for a minute, and box select, I've done exactly the same thing. I've only selected the ones I could see. So if I have xRay on and box select, now look, I've selected them all the way through, so I can hit the delete button and delete the vertices, and now I have what I want. So let's return to solid view because it's easy to see what I'm doing. Now what I want to do is I want to create like a foot, a pedestal for it to stand on. What I want to do is I want to, with edge mode selected, I want to be able to select this ring all the way around here, and I could do it by shift. Whoops, I made a mistake there, I selected the wrong one, but you know, that's a slow way of doing it. There's an alternative way, which is alt. So if I do alt and I select a line, it selects that line all the way through. If I select alt and that line, I get the ring that I want, which is great. So let's go into right hand view again, and I can extrude this down, so it's just past this apex point here. So extrude just on the z-axis, and that's my little pedestal at the bottom. Okay, so I've now got a bowl, but see, it's very, very, there's no structure to it. It's just a paper thin bowl. So we can solidify this, make it a bit thicker. I want it about 2 mil thick, I think. And there's a modifier that does that for me. So add modifier, solidify. There you can see I've now got a rather chunky looking bowl. So I don't like. But I can change it because it's 1 centimeter thick by the looks of it. I can change that to 2 millimeters. That's a much better, neater looking bowl, I think. You can see the thickness around the edge here. But it's still a bit, it's all, I can still see all these facets here. If I go into object mode, if I right click option, I've got shade smooth. That's looking a bit better, but I can still see the shapes. I still don't like that. There's another modifier, which I can't remember if we used or not yet, which is the subdivision surface modifier, and this will add extra detail to it. And if we take the viewpoint up to 2, you can see I've now got a nice smooth bowl. Ideal. So let's add some, let's go into preview mode, and we'll add some material texture to this bowl. New, let's call it silver. We want a base color that is very slightly blue, but not a lot, subtly blue. We want it to be metallic, so that goes all the way up to 1. It's either on or off metallic, and roughness needs to come right down. And there we have, yours might look slightly different. I've got HDRI on, which has given me these interesting colours. Yours should look a lot plainer than that. So there we go. We have a shiny bowl. Now, if we look on a normal view, we have our world origin there, and we have a dot in the middle. The dot in the middle is actually the origin of this bowl. So if I just click on this one, I can move the world origin out of the way. That's now the 3D cursor. The origin of this object is still there. It's in the center of where the sphere was. I would like to move it to this bottom, where this bottom ring is, so I can then easily place this on the table. So if you do Shift S, you get a pie menu, and it allows us to move the 3D cursor to selected. And at the moment I've got that bottom ring still selected. If you haven't, obviously you can reselect it. So now that 3D cursor, as you see, is sat right at the bottom there, but my origin of my object is still up here. So I go to object mode. One of the options of object is set origin, and I can set origin to 3D cursor and select the object. Select, make sure the object is selected, go object, set origin, 3D cursor. So now they're both at the same place, which is ideal. Okay, so now we can move our object onto our table. So just grab it, slide it up, put it up here roughly, slide it across, move it across here roughly, go right hand view, go up a bit, and this is a bit tedious to try and get it dead on the table. But with the, now we've got the origin here, we can use this tool here, which is, looks like a magnet. It's actually a snapping tool, and we can snap to a face. And now it's changed it to this square shape. Now let's just zoom in a little bit. Now if I do grab now, it will try and sit on that face. See, doesn't matter where I move it, it's trying to sit back on that face. So that's a perfect way of getting it to sit where you want it to. Okay, so we've now got a fruit bowl. Let's move it over here a little bit more. There we go, sat on our table. So at this point, it's probably a good idea to save. File, save as. So we've created our fruit bowl. So now let's create a plate so we can put some meat, butter, whatever else on the plate and start putting some more things on our table. I've got my floor displayed. I want to hide that. You might not have, so I'm just going to select that and press H. My 3D cursor, I prefer to have at the world origin when I'm working. So I'm going to do Shift S, cursor to world origin. I don't know what I just did then. Cursor to world origin. There we are. Right, so we're going to create a plate, and we're going to start off using a circle. Circle's far too big. Let's make it a lot smaller. I reckon about 12 centimeter radius is about right. We'll leave those number of vertices in there. We could fill it, but I prefer to start off without filling it, and you'll understand why in a bit. Okay, so let's focus in on this. So with it selected, focus in on it. And we'll go to top view. There we go. Now you would think that if I was in edit mode with tab, that I could right click and loop cut and slide. I'll get a message here that says select a ring to be cut, and I can't. So it's not allowing me to do loop cut and slide. So my next guess would be I need to do an extrude. So I do, oh, no, that's not what I want to do. That's extruding all over the place. So let's a quick understanding what normals are. So normals are each of these vertices and faces has a normal direction in which it is looking, I suppose is the easiest way of doing it. And we can show those briefly. So all these vertices are looking in this direction outwards, which is what you'd probably expect. So I want to be able to extrude just on the normals. If we look at our extrude option here and hold down, one of the options is extrude along normals. So, okay, now this little bar appears, and if I move this in and out, ah, that's exactly what I'm getting. You see those, the extrusions are following the lines of those blue normals that we put in. So let's extrude so we get a ring in the middle, which would be the flat center of the base, and that's ideal. So let's just turn that off for a minute, get rid of that, and let's get rid of those normals because I think I found it a bit confusing, but they were quite useful to explain. Now I can loop cut and slide. It's the first one, so go into that, happy with that. Another one in there, and another one in there. Notice, I don't know if I told you this before, that where the loop cut goes depends on which edge you're near. Okay, so now I've got some things to play with. So what you think what I want to do is now make this into a curve shape. Now you think what I could do is I could alt as we did before, select that ring, and I could grab that and put it down on the Z axis a little bit, and I could grab this one. I could alt select this one, and I could grab this and put it down on the Z, and it's a bit fiddly trying to get everything perfect. So let's undo those control Zs. There's an easier way of doing it. So that's back to where it was. One of the things we've got is a tool called proportional editing, which is this inconspicuous little dot up here. Shortcut 0 if you want to use it. Now, if I just select the inner ring, which is like that, and I grab that on the Z axis, you can see up the top I get this dialog box appears. It's hard to show you because everything's going to move. And I get this circle. If you can't see the circle, it's probably because it's out here. You see how proportional size is too big? You can't see it. If you scroll on your mouse wheel, you can control the size of this circle. And as I move it in and out, you can see I get a curve shape. If I get it in very tight, I'm only going to move the central ones. If I get it in very wide enough, then I'm going to move them all. If I go partway between the two, I'm keeping the outside flatter than the others. So I'm going to control Z that for a minute. I'm going to start again. So I'm going to grab on the Z axis. I'm going to ignore the outside rim, and I'm going to pull it down slightly. Let go. Turn off proportional editing because I don't want it on the rest of the time. You see, I've got this gentle curve of my plate, which is kind of ideal. Actually, I probably want it a bit more, actually. You reckon? Let's turn it on again and pull it down a little bit more. Grab on the Z axis, down a little bit more. There we go. I'll turn it off. Now you can understand the reason why I didn't have the center done, because I didn't want to distort the shape of the center. I want that to be flat. So I'm going to fill this face. So I'm going to do face. I could do a fill like this, and that gives you this weird shape. I don't really like that. There is a way of filling it, so I fan fill, so I get the central space. But remember, we talked about nGons and stuff earlier. The grid fill gives me nice neat quads in the center. So I've now got my plate, which is paper thin. So we could add a solidify modifier as we did with the bowl. So add, modify, solidify. I reckon about 3 millimeters for a china plate, not 1 centimeter. It's a bit chunky. There we go. Got a lot of angles and faces on it, so we could add a smooth as we did last time. Subdivision surface modifier, give that a level of 2. We'll quickly look at that in object mode. That's looking pretty neat. We could even add a shade smooth to that, right click and shade smooth. So it's looking good, but it's looking a bit bland. And part of the reason is plates tend to have a rim on the bottom. So let's go back into edit mode, the tab, and we could add a rim to the bottom. But notice I've got vertices and meshes on the top here. Actually, if I go to vertex mode, you can see them, but I haven't the bottom. And that's because the bottom doesn't really exist. It's been created by the solidify modifier. So what I want to do is apply that solidify modifier so I can add a rim to the bottom. If I click on this down arrow, there's an option to apply, but it's grayed out. And that reason is you can only do that when you're in object mode. And it says it here, disable this modifier operation is not allowed from edit mode. So go back to object mode, click apply, back to edit mode, and now you can see I've got vertices top and bottom, which is what you expect to see. So let's go back to edge mode. I wanted to create a little rim around here for it to sit on, so I can do a loop cut and slide. I can pull that in to about there. Ideal. Return that. I want another one. I want it within there. Okay, now let's go to right view. I can grab this on the Z axis. I can pull it down slightly. Give myself a rim. There we go. Object mode. I have a completed plate. Looking good. So I need to add a material to this. New, let's call it China white in case we had another China. Base colors white. Yes, I like that. You could pick a pale blue or anything you like, actually. Let's go for a pale blue. Why not? Or any other color you feel like. It shouldn't be metallic, but it should be relatively smooth. So we'll put it down to about there. That'll do. So I've now got a nice blue plate. So let's do the same trick as we did last time with the origin. So in edit mode, I've still got my ring selected. If not, you can reselect it. I can do Shift S, cursor to selected, which means my cursor down there. I go to object mode. I can do object set origin to 3D cursor. Not selected, and selected it. Sorry, object set origin 3D cursor. In actual fact, I have that on my quick favorites. You remember how to do that? It was object set origin, right click. I've already got it. So it says remove. If you haven't got it, you could always add it to there. So now with my snapping tool on, I can grab that and I can grab that and I can put it on the table roughly. Let's get it about right. I notice because of the grabbings, the snappings on, it snapped it straight to that table. Okay, happy with that. Then we can make our floor reappear. We can either click the little icon there or we could use the Alt H button, either way. And now we can save this. And I could just save it on the top of as where it was rather than increment it.
Hope you've learned something from this tutorial and enjoyed watching it. If you have, then please click like. I'd also appreciate if you could support this channel by clicking subscribe. I put the next video in this series on how to create a mug, and it's available now on this card. Keep in touch, and I hope to see you soon.